गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, हाय माय सेल्फ इस किरण सर, वेलकम्स यू आर बैक मैथ्स ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। हाउ आर यू फ्रेंड्स? आई होप दैट यू ऑल आर डूइंग वेल एंड कंटिन्यूइंग योर स्टडी। यू आर कंप्लीटेड, यू आर डूइंग दैट चैप्टर्स विच द क्लासेस इज गोइंग ऑन, विच आई यूज्ड टू टीच, and I hope that no problems may be there. If you have the problems, many times I have told to all of you that you can ask your query if anywhere, any questions you have the problem, collect my number from the WhatsApp group and just send me the messages. Okay students, so students, one more thing is that I want to know how and what type of experience you are experiencing in the duration of lockdown or in the duration of COVID-19, when the virtual classes is going on instead of physical classes. So these things, I hope that is completely new for us, and we have to promote ourselves like that. We have to prepare ourselves like that. So in coming times, what are the problems, what are the issues, if they create, we can be ready for that. For the students, this time I will continue without break the chapters, the topics which I delivered the last video. After that we will continue now, but before that you all have to be take out the textbook, notebooks and get ready with the topics. And students, one more thing, after watching the videos, in last videos already I told you, if you watch the videos, if the concept is clear, kindly subscribe the channels and comment what you wish. Okay, as for the videos, you can comment, like and share the videos. Okay students, so get ready with the textbook for today's class. Students, today's class, I hope it is the last class for the rational number. Okay students, so after that, after this video, you will get the question answer session. You will get the question answer session where I will use to solve not all questions, I will use to solve only important questions which is given in the exercise 1, 2, 3. Okay students, if supposed to be 10 questions are given, among that only 2 or 3 questions I will describe on the board, and rest of all you have to do by yourself. Okay, so you have to prepare yourself on that way. It's important, you have to prepare on that way. You have to clarify the concept what the classes we are conducting. So students, get ready. Okay, see students, a topic is that terminating decimal. Terminating decimal. I think students, in decimal chapters they don't have a study about the terminating decimal, but here we are studying about the terminating decimal. What is terminating decimal? Students, in a rational number, when we used to divide, when a number, when a fraction or when a rational number present in the form of p by q. P by q, it means supposed to be 5 by 8, 6 by 2. In such a way, what we have to do? It means p by q is the form of p by q, and as we know that in the form of numerator or denominator, numerator is always divided by denominator. It means 2 3 6. It is not dividing. It will divide as a decimal 0. Then 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 P can be divided by Q. Okay, so let's discuss about the terminating decimal. In terminating decimal, what you have to do? It's an example for a better understanding, for a better concept. But I am talking about the terminating decimal. Terminating decimal, it means what? We can say that having the finite, having the finite number of, having the finite number of digits in the decimal part. Okay students, in the decimal number P can be divided by Q. In such cases, sometimes a number which can divide completely without decimal, but sometimes we will find that numbers can't divide. Sometimes a number can't divide and the same number is repeating again and again. So in the same way, there are many types of number may be come. If you will want to start up to do the question that way, you can say as example what I took now 5 by 8. Suppose to be example is 5 by 8, and as per the definition, having the finite number, do you know what is finite number? Finite number, it means fixed number. Okay, it means somewhere it is limited. Finite number, it means limited number. Okay, when you once start the divide, it will complete divide. It means complete divide means remainder will be 0 after 2, 3, 4, 5 steps dividing. Okay, see that 5 by 8 as example. What will happen? That 5 will, it means numerator will divide by denominator C. Number 8, they are dividing. Now it is greater than this one. It means divisor divided dividend. The dividend is less than divisor. In such condition, what will we do? Simple, we will put by 0 and we will put here 0, then decimal. Okay, 8 is the 48. What will be there? 2, 0, 8 to the 16, 4 cancel, 0, 8 times the 40. See students, it is called terminating decimal. This decimal and after decimal, only 3 digits are there. In 3 steps, remainder becomes 0 or cancelled. Such types of questions, such types of decimal is called finite number decimal. Okay, having the finite number of digits in the decimal part. See, in the decimal part, only 3 digits are there. It means not more than 3 digits. It cannot be repeated more. Okay, why? The thing is that remainder becomes 0. That's why it is called terminating decimal. Simple students, have you got what I want to say? Having the finite number of digits, it means when you will divide any rational number in such condition, as a quotient, decimal part will be limit. Decimal part and decimal part will be finite number, not infinite number. Okay, somewhere it will be a stop dividing. Why it will be a stop? Due to its remainder becomes 0. Okay students, see, if I talk about the next part, second topic is that non-terminating decimal. So this time erase it. It's called non-terminating decimal. Can you say students, what is non-terminating decimal? Good question. Simple method, opposite of terminating. In terminating, what was there? Having the finite number of digits, but here infinite number of digits. Simple, you can say that having infinite, it means indefinite, infinite. N dot stands for number, infinite number of digits. In decimal part. Okay students, it means non-terminating. As we have seen in this question, after dividing, what happens? Quotient stops. Why? Due to its remainder becomes 0. Remainder becomes cancelled. In same way, in non-terminating decimal, having infinite number of digits in decimal form. Why it is infinite number of decimals? the thing is that you can say that, see as an example, 2 by 11. In this condition, what will happen? In a question, same number will be repeated. Are you getting my points? You can say that the repeating or recurring. Okay, you can say that repeating or recurring. See, 2 by 11 is there. In such condition, what we will do? We will divide. It is not possible. Put here 0 point. Is my element 0. Given on the 11. And cancel 0, 11 at the 88. So cancel 0, 1. So students, I hope you can observe what happened in this condition, in these questions. In this question, you can observe that same number is repeating. Same number is repeating again and again, and it will be continuous. It will not stop anywhere. It will be continuous. So that it is called non-terminating decimal. In such conditions, what you will do? Simply you can write 0.18 bar. It is called bar. That means it shows that this number will repeat again and again. The number which will repeat, you can represent as a warp nut number. Okay students, so I think you have clarified about the non-terminating decimal. So on the basis of this one, few questions may ask in the chapters 4.2 or in the review exercise. So students, I hope you have understood regarding this topic, but I want to show one more topic is there. See which one. See students, next topic is that non-repeating decimal. Non-terminating, we have seen terminating, non-terminating. Now we will see non-repeating decimal. In this condition, what will be happen? Number will not repeat, but it will be in quotient and finite number of decimal. See as example. Students, it means in such condition, what will be happen when you will divide? Simple, see, 3 is there. Now I will put decimal 0, 7 for the 28, 2, cancel 1, 0, 7 to the 14. 6 cancel 0, 7 at the 56, 0, 7 6 are 42, 7 5 are 35. It means it will be divided, but number will not, the same number will not repeat. Same number will not repeat, but remainder also will not be 0. In such conditions, we will say non-repeating decimal. Why? Because question will found infinite number, remainder will not be cancelled, remainder will not be 0, but it will be infinite number of question. That's why it is called non-repeating decimal. So, students, on the basis of this all topic, few questions have given in the review exercise. So, do the review exercise also. And in the next video, we will see the question answer session. Okay, that's all. Thank you.